What's up, everybody? Derek G here. Feed the Fire Films. And I've been wanting to do this for a couple of years now. I've been wanting to attempt to build a labyrinth out here somewhere. I figured I'm gonna go try and scope out a spot big enough and flat enough, I guess. Doesn't actually have to be, well, there's nothing really flat out here, obviously. Level, I should say. Level enough to build a labyrinth. You need a pretty big area, because it's the labyrinth is comprised of 12 concentric rings that fall in on each other. And in order to make a path wide enough for someone to walk through, you need about an area like, you know, at least, at the smallest, like 60 feet, a 60-foot diameter circle. So you actually have space to travel in to walk through the labyrinth and get to the center and have an actual center to stand in or sit in or whatever. You have to leave that extra space in for that middle circle for some room. So, but everything is like really a lot of trees out here. There's really not that many wide open areas. And of course, the last thing I want to do is cut down trees. But there are a few spots that are kind of a ways out here, but I would much rather have it out in the middle of nowhere where nobody will just kind of stumble across it, you know? You'd have to like kind of almost get lost to find it. And so that's the plan today. Is to find an area big enough that's close enough to one of these old stone walls. To be honest, that's another factor, because I'm only one dude. I can only carry so much. I'm not Edward Lead Scallion. I don't know how to float 1-ton stones by myself. Even though that's possible, I kind of wish I knew how, because if I did, then I'd be able to build some crazy shit out here. Right now, I gotta go stop off at what we call the Vectagon. Look at that. Almost walked through that kind of shit. Go around, I think. Yeah, we call this geometric structure a vectagon, because it's just half. It's half of a vector equilibrium. Yeah. It's four triangles put together on a hexagon base. Or you could just look at it as three squares leaning in on each other with a hexagon base. Don't look like anything is falling. Look at all these balanced stones I made, right? Oh, fucking human, man. Look at that. Awesome. I figured the deer might knock it over, but don't look that way. Quiet out here. Oh. for me. Everything in here looks good. What I need to do is dig up, find out where we hid the twine. A spool of twine, man. Because I need to measure.
Spider.
There we go. I could probably measure and cut this shit now. Right? Hold up a second, everybody. Let me do that. I'll be right back. Did you guys just see those deer? I don't know. I'm still out here, so I haven't looked at the footage, but that deer had to get caught over there at that shot, man. But anyway, got this. Gonna grab this. Put this shit in my bag. I wonder what they were running from. They were running from that direction. Like they came from out there and ran through. You know, the one just ran right through here. And there was two more that I probably didn't see that ran across that way. Maybe, I don't know. Everything's dried up. See how dense and thick it is out here. It's almost impossible to find an open area like the one I'm looking for. That's why I kind of have a few spots that I know are already kind of open in a way. Just gotta check to see if they're be level enough. Wow, whoa. Damn, man, a lot of spider webs. Believe it or not, this actually used to be the trail right here. Where I'm walking. This is where the trail was. Except nobody comes out here anymore. So there is no more trail. It's kind of cleared out down in there, but it gets kind of swampy down in there. And there is a ton of trees. I mean, if I could find one tree that has 35 feet of clearance all the way around from all sides, and then we could put a tree in the middle. Wow. This is kind of this from this year in the spring. I'm thinking up here by this wall. That was my first thought. I know nobody knows what I'm talking about because I'm the only one who can think about what this is up here. there's a kind of a wide opening spot. There's some big trees down. They took a lot of trees down with them when they fell. And it's not that far away from this stone wall, which is really a stone wall built in the 1860s, I believe, to herd the cattle, keep the cattle grazing over here and then grazing over there. And so this is new, fresh woodlands, because the farms and everything closed down in the early 1900s, World War I. And everything was like abandoned, I guess. See this spot up here? I don't know, it's too, there's no way I'm gonna get 60 feet there. No way, this is only 30 feet. There are those big trees. Let's go take a look. Yeah, that's fresh. Yeah, this looks like it might have fallen last night or today. Fresh. Yeah, man, things just grow in. This is a big spot, huh? Still no 60 foot diameter. There's no way to cut the labyrinth down to scale like you could in, well, I haven't figured it out. I haven't really tried. Maybe there is a way to cut it down to 6 concentric rings, where I would only need like an area like this big, 30 foot diameter, 35 foot diameter. But then, you know, it'd be a mini one. It'd be like a little mini labyrinth, where it should really have 12 concentric rings, because of the way you walk through it. You end up walking around the whole thing, in and out, in and out, in and out, to get to the center. I'll put a picture up on the screen and show you guys. We walked, me and my lady walked the labyrinth up at Alex Gray's Cosm. But again, he had to cut down and clear out a whole area in the woods just to get an area big enough to make it. You know, so there's all tree stumps in it and all kinds of roots and things. I'm just looking for a wide open space out here, dude. Big enough. But I don't know, man. I'm not sure I'm gonna find one. See, there's another spot that's probably like 30 feet across. But 60 feet? Twice that, man? Near one of these walls? I don't think it's gonna happen, dude. So maybe I'll just build something right here in this space. With some of these rocks. A little temple or altar or, you know, build a stone circle and balance some stones in the middle, I guess. I don't know. I'm not gonna do it today, though. I really want to build a labyrinth, man. I wish I had a spot to do it. Yeah. It takes a long time to walk through the labyrinth, too, to get to the center. Yeah, and it's all one path. You probably do like 48 freaking turns and just turnarounds and through the whole thing. I haven't counted, I'm guessing, because I figure it's multiples of 12. So, and it's split into fours. So that was my plan, was to create a circle out here with that rope, you know, put my stick in the center, scratch out a circle on the ground from there, and then create a plus across the middle of it. And then that's where you basically start with the cross of the zodiac, if you want to call it that. I don't know. Sometimes it's the symbol for the planet Earth, a circle with a plus across through it. I don't know, man. Can't go much further out. It just gets swampy and more dense. This is like the only kind of empty area. Things are a little bit spread out, like, you know, you got room right here. But again, it's only like a 30 foot, it's only like 30 feet from me to that tree. And you might have 30 feet between these two, maybe. And there's no way I'm gonna cut these three trees down to, you know what I'm saying? Besides, I wouldn't want to anyway. Yeah. Like that. Whatever. Freaking humid and shit. So yeah, I don't know, man. Maybe I'll go home and try and figure out how to split it in half, if you can. Because that's the whole catch with it, is that when you walk in, you walk like halfway in, and then loop right around and go all the way to the center, and you get led back out. And so without having, you know, oh, again, these fucking huge spider webs, man. You probably can't see them on the camera, but dude. Wow. And then there's nothing here between these two trees. It's kind of crazy. It's like if I was a spider, I would think I would pick between the two trees instead of this wide open spot in the middle of nowhere. I don't know, dude. There's some kind of, it's hilly right here. That's the problem. Like, there's some wide open spots here. Like, you see? Right there. If I was to sacrifice those two little trees and use this one as the center, I might have 30 feet, 30 feet, and 30 feet, and I could build it right in here inside all these trees. With only sacrificing these two little ones, which are probably only a couple decades old. 10 or 20 years old. But again, this is a really unlevel spot. It's not too far away from the walls, I guess, but dude, like I said, I'm just one guy. So I don't know, it looks like the deer come running right through here. Look at that. Yeah, they come right through here. All right, anyway, let me walk back to the campsite. And I'll recap at the end. I don't know what the fuck I'm gonna do, but whatever. We'll see. Yeah, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have no idea what to do. Uh, nowhere else to check. I probably won't ever do it. It's a good idea. And I might build something at that one spot out there by that wall. But as for a labyrinth, I just don't have the room. Don't have the room. I can't find a spot. Yeah. So. Oh well. Yeah. So it's kind of sucks, but maybe I'll figure out a way to make a half labyrinth my own self. We'll see what I can come up with. Yeah. No. All right. I'll catch everybody later. Peace, love, and gratitude. And namaste to all of you. And get out in nature whenever you can, because it's healthy for you. It's beautiful out here. But, alright, peace, everyone.